You are not big enough to accuse the whole age effectively. But let us say you are in dissent. You are in no position to issue commands, but you can speak words of hope. Shall this be the substance of your message? Be human in this most inhuman of ages. Guard the image of man, for it is the image of God. Thomas Merton wrote those words, and he actually goes on to say, if you agree with that, then if that's your cause or belief or the way that you want to live, that's great, but you're going to be pushing against the age. You're going to be pushing against, you won't make many friends necessarily. You have a destiny to be misunderstood or that kind of thing. So that's part of it. That's just part of it. I think this passage has a couple of different ideas that are almost two completely different things we could talk about. I'm going to try to hit both of them just a little bit. The first part is, that most of us, if not all of us, are not big enough to accuse the whole age. The world has been going for thousands of years in terms of history, and the oppression and the violence and the difficulties, the weather, everything, but the systems of man that we've invented, they've been going on for a long time. They're big. And I don't want to say that one person can't make a difference, because that's the only person that can make a difference is one person. And you never know when the last sand grain will fall and, you know, create bigger changes, strike the first domino so that all the rest of the dominoes go down. But for most of us, it's a lot quieter than that. And a lot of times we're planting seeds that we may not even see in our lifetime. It depends. But we have to keep doing that, because it's how we want to be. It's who we are. We cannot, if we choose it, we cannot be any other kind of person. And so my invitation is to always think it's worth it. Even if you cannot issue commands and your only job can be to issue words of hope, take it. Take that job. It's a good job. And if you find yourself in a position to issue commands, although that's not really the way to approach human beings, even if you think it's for the right reasons, but you kind of get what Brother Merton is trying to come up with. And it can be daunting, but it also can be very such a very rich way to live life, to do some accusing and do some hoping. And when I say accusing, I don't necessarily mean to, I don't know that condemnation is always the best route, but we do need to be clear about what's going on and talk about it clearly, bring things into the light, and be definite about what we do and do not want to participate in, and encourage others to do the same. The other part of this passage has to do with being inhuman in this most inhuman of ages and guarding the image of man, for it is the image of God. And I almost don't really have anything other to say than that, because that's it. Being human is not an inferior experience. It is an extremely holy experience. We are here in our struggle, and a lot of us have a lot of pain. We have confusion, but instead of rejecting these experiences, to have joy in them, to be glad we're alive. Kind of like having dirty dishes means that we were eating, right? But it's also, you can apply that larger, the fact that we can skin our knees or get into accidents or have arguments or have things break means that we're here. There's trees and there's rocks and there's all the things that we're building. And sometimes we do take ourselves too seriously and think that all the things that are set up for us in the systems to participate in are the thing, when really mostly what we have to do here is breathe and enjoy. And you know, we do have to handle whatever's before us, but there's usually a lot of creativity, and if we can widen our minds to that. But it is holy to be us. It is a holy thing. And God is in us. And the image of Jesus, actually a lot of, I think even Lord Krishna, there's an image of God being human. That is the image. One of Jesus's names is Emmanuel, God with us. And that God with us is us. And so whatever image we create ourselves into to be a part of this world is how far God can get in. So like shining our light is shining God's light. And I'm not really saying exactly how that is to be done, because we all have weaknesses and we all have strengths, and we need to give each other the benefit of the doubts for our weaknesses and leave lots of room for our strengths. So, you know, it's a mixed bag, but it's not, it's all important. And so treasure yourself and treasure other human beings, no matter what condition they're in. Even if they are the oppressors, if they're the oppressors, it's still us, it's still part of us. And somewhere they got taught how to be oppressors. So it's a never-ending loop of, and also the people who are downtrodden, who got on the bottom of some of our systems, how they got there, that's all the image of God. And we're all in the process of rising up out of the tomb. So I don't think I said anything better than what Thomas Merton said, though. So that's worth, his quotation is worth pondering on, and just keep chipping away at what this world is and keep enjoying it. And that is what is holy.